The fate of these young undocumented immigrants rests on the country's highest court. With next week's Supreme Court hearing on the Obama-era Deferred Action for Childhood Arrivals program, or DACA, which has provided deportation relief as well as work and travel permits to hundreds of thousands. Oral arguments will be heard on November 12th, stemming from lawsuits challenging President Donald Trump's decision to end DACA. A ruling is expected sometime next year.
It is 800,000 lives that's going to be at risk, whatever the decision of the Supreme Court is. And really it's important for not just DACA recipients to understand what's happening, because it will have implications around kind of the abilities of immigrants to have protection in the United States, and really for DACA recipients to know that if their DACA renewal is going to expire within the next year, to really consider renewing as soon as possible by contacting a lawyer or a community-based organization that provides that service.
Nung and other DACA recipients and immigrant rights advocates recently met with California Senator Kamala Harris's staff at the UCLA Labor Center in downtown Los Angeles.
Senator Harris joined her Senate colleagues in an amicus brief urging the Supreme Court to protect DACA recipients and our idea of welcoming immigrants. Senator Harris will fight till dreamers have a fair shot of the American dream.
Harris was expected to join them but had to stay in Washington, D.C. for hearings related to the ongoing impeachment process against President Trump. Among those joining the conversation, the senator's Filipino-American Deputy Director for Immigration, Catherine Patanco. Patanco works with Harris's office in inspecting immigrant detention centers and monitoring rapid response networks, as well as keeping the community in the loop regarding immigration issues.
I think what's really great and unique about this role, especially working for the senator, is that with our convening power like today, we're able to bring folks together to have these conversations and to make those connections.
Senator Harris plays a very key role in the Senate nationally, just really being one of our leaders around immigrant rights and immigration issues, and then to be able to really be more in touch with the people of California, specifically those who have DACA, folks who have TPS, who are undocumented, to really understand what the struggle looks like and how she can help move the conversation forward around what relief can look like.
Harris is also among the 16 candidates vying for the Democratic presidential nomination. Advocates said while they're keeping a close watch on the Supreme Court hearing next week, they're looking ahead at 2020, finding permanent solutions to immigration issues such as DACA, TPS, and family reunification. Steve Angeles, ABS-CBN News, Los Angeles.
She's the immigration caseworker.